Preparing to stream live. Redirecting to YouTube. Perfect. Turn the volume off. You got 2 minutes left, right?
Yep.
All right, can you test this live stream link and make sure that it works?
Sure, where is it?
I'm putting it in the Zoom chat directly to you.
I see. Yep, it's working.
All right, perfect. All right, so everything looks good, right? You can see the screen. I can see you. All right, let's go live.
All right, cool. All right. And I'm going to let people in.
Cool.
Hello, everyone. Thank you for being patient in the waiting room. We were setting up our stream. Greetings, greetings. All right, got somebody else in the waiting room. We are gonna wait just a couple of minutes to get started to just make sure some people trickle in, but I wanna make sure that everybody says hi. Looks like we have a couple of new people here today. Looks like we have some people returning from yesterday. So make sure you say hi in the chat. And I'm wondering, what questions do you have about haiku, either as a first day participant or, you know, maybe something that was evoked from our discussion yesterday? So what question was brought up? You take some time, put that in the chat, that we can maybe talk about it. See, I'm adding Datum to the room. Hey, what's up, Datum? All right, IQ is back in the room. Hello, everyone. Adam, I like your wolf shirt.
Thanks. I have a lot of wolf shirts. Oh, man. It's been hectic. We were just playing a pretty crazy children in the middle.
You've got all the kids with you today?
Yep. They just sat down for dinner. We have someone coming. I'll have to take a little break. We have someone coming to pick up some furniture.
Okay.
And I'll hop back on. But it'll be playing in the background so I can follow.
Yeah. Well, you know, that's why I kind of like haiku, because I think haiku is for writers who don't have time to write. So, like,
I actually wrote mine today, revised and completely scrapped the one from yesterday and figured mine out at work today, where I probably should have been doing real things.
No, you should be writing.
So. No, I didn't even write. It just popped into my head and then I put it into text and then that way.
That's kind of writing. So here we have, all right. We got 12 people in the room. I'm going to wait like one more minute. I don't see any questions yet, but I see a couple people turn on their screens. Hi, Jerry. How's it going? It's good to see you. I'm really glad that you can make it. Oh, you're on mute, Jerry.
Oh. Hey, glad to be here. I hated last night.
You said what?
I hate that I missed last night.
Oh, it's okay. We got more coming today, so it's always good to see you. I'm glad you're here.
Look at that bear I see.
Yeah, bear's here too. Like, isn't it like old times?
Yeah.
Like, I love, Bear, I love your smile. Like, every time you smile, like, it makes me so happy. It's really good to see you.
Thank you. I was cursed to have the smile of a child and the pain of an old man.
That is almost a haiku, like, in itself. Have you put that line somewhere, like, in one of your poems?
I'm sure it's somewhere in some form, but not that form.
Oh, all right. Shadow, I think I'm going to take control. Looks like we have a couple people. We might have a couple more people bleed in, though. So I'm going to share my screen. All right, so I'm going to do a couple things. Probably should have set this up before I shared my screen. That would have been smart. But, you know, I'm not known for making smart decisions on the fly all the time.
IQ.
So I'm going to share something in the chat. I like this, like a reunion.
Oh, it is totally, because I haven't seen her since this.
Wow. Oh, man.
Miss you so much.
I will say this. My partner, Siren, that's where I met my partner, Siren, in one of those bouts. And then we didn't see each other for 4 years. And then we reconnected at Southern Fried. Now we're like madly in love. That it was a meaningful Southern Fried to me. So I'm glad seeing that.
So Fried in general is about mad love. Like, yeah, straight up. That's what I tell people. I say, you know, it's a slam, but really it's my family reunion, you know. I actually like going to Southern Fried more than I like going to my real family reunion half the time.
So I thank you again for bearing with me as I fumble through my PowerPoint. It's like I need to get like one of those cool setups like Shadow has with like multiple screens, and I have one of those in like my office because I'm trying to like have a PowerPoint and like stream at the same time, and I don't know what I'm doing. All right, so just like last time, we're going to start with the mindfulness mission. If you were here yesterday, we talked about the notion of kigo words. Basically, like, these are words in Japanese literature that evoke the seasons, or and a lot of them have kind of some very specific connotations culturally in the history of the writing. Like, we talked about cherry blossoms the other day, often signifying autumn, which can signify like death or passing or longing or something like that. So in the chat, I just shared a list of 500 kigo words, a dictionary, like this is called Saijiki, I think. I think I'm pronouncing that correctly. So what I want you to do is just look at this list of kigo words and pick out five-ish that kind of like relate to you. And this has kind of been a tradition in Japanese haiku writing that some people are considered spring poets. Some people are considered autumn poets. So it wouldn't be that amiss if you related to some of these kigo words. So just take a couple of minutes, and I want you to like make a list of like five that you want to play with today. So we got somebody else in the waiting room. And I think I have to, if someone could cut and paste and put that back into the chat, that would be helpful. Because I think that every time somebody new comes into the chat, I have to share this again. Thank you. I appreciate it, Cobras. So yes, back to my screen. Is everybody able to access the document? It was like one of those .html addresses. So.
I'm the technically challenged one. I can't find it.
That's okay. Are you attending through your phone? Is that maybe one of the...
No, I'm on a laptop.
Okay. Well, if you go to, let me see if I can just pull up.
Here it is.
Oh, you found it? So,
well,
yeah, if you go.
You pulled it up, I guess, and it was there for a second and then went away.
If you go down, do you see where it says chat at the bottom of your screen, Jerry? If you like hover your icon over the bottom, it should say like mute, stop video, security, participants.
I must be on a different screen than you. Oh, no, I lost you completely.
You don't have any like place on your screen where you can like mute or unmute your microphone?
That I have, but now I've just like completely lost the meeting. I've hidden it from myself somewhere on my screen and can't find it.
Well, Jerry, you're a pro. I think you might know about. I think you, if you can't access it, I know you know about some Kigo. Oh, you found it?
I see the chat now.
All right, let's take two more minutes to find a few Kigo that you really like.
Are these the words under like the different headings for seasons?
Yeah, so you have a Kigo that correlates to a season. So like if you look in spring and animals, like pheasants and swallows are usually something you'd use to signify spring. You go to summer, they have like summer of the earth, summer that is like kind of like observances. So the Kigo is really kind of in reference to something like atmospheric or environmental, something that correlates specifically to a season. And this is why the trying to define a haiku in English is difficult, because we don't have, our metaphors just don't work the same way, if that makes sense.
Okay.
So maybe you want to, maybe you're drawn to write a poem about chrysanthemums, or maybe yesterday we looked at lilies. Pick a couple of these Kigo that you feel like you might be able to play with today. All right, so if you're starting to find some good ones, drop the ones that you want to play with today into the chat if you can. You're like, hey man, I want to write about dew today, morning dew. Susan, you're going to write about waterfalls and fireflies. I didn't know this until I started hosting a summer camp for teen poets, that like a large part of the South, in particular where our festival takes place, people don't have fireflies. I think that's really interesting. Kendra, you said afterglow. You're going to write about the afterglow. And forgive me, I realize that some people are switching around accounts. If I'm calling you the wrong name. So take 60 more seconds. Maybe find one or two Kigo that you think might be good to play with today. Bear, you got tadpoles. That's a good one. That's such a Japanese poem, tadpoles. I love that. Wisteria, I don't know what wisteria is.
Like a flowering tree.
Yeah.
Yeah, I loved catching tadpoles when I was a kid. I'm a big lizard turtle guy. Turtles are my favorite, but lizards and amphibians and things like that, I love that. My poem's gonna be wet, y'all.
Wet. I like that. Hey, Jerry, we're getting like a buzz. Will you try muting your mic and see if that's what it is?
Okay, hold on. How do I back out of this screen? Hold on. Oh, wow.
Oh.
Shadow. It's a shadow, I'm sorry.
All right, that did help. Thank you.
Say hi.
I don't want you to stay muted though, so please unmute periodically because I feel very honored. If a lot of you don't know, so you know they talk about Japanese masters, like if anyone can name the four Japanese masters, it's Basho, Busan, Issa, and Shiki. If there was a English master, Jerry Hardesty would be one of them in my heart. So I'm very happy that you're here, Jerry. So all that's to say is don't mute yourself the whole time. Awesome. It looks like we have a lot of cool Kigo. We're just like our warm-up yesterday. We're going to play with these words just a little bit. And thank you for bearing with us while we figure out some of the technology stuff. So I'm going to share my screen again. Welcome to day two of Henzbo Haiku Hullabaloo. There's the screen. All right, so the Kigo I wanted to pick was the moon. I am just fascinated by the moon. I think it's a good haiku. Like, who hasn't written a haiku about the moon? All of us look at the moon. So this is an autumn Kigo. A lot of people think of in Japanese haiku. If you're running with the moon, this is maybe something like autumn. But there are some specific like summer moons, spring moons and things like that. So I want to look at a few haiku that use the Kigo of the moon. And I want you guys to put on your detective hats today. And I'm going to ask you, what is happening in the cut of this haiku? So this is by Ryokan. He wrote, "The thief left it behind, the moon at my window." I don't know if anyone's familiar with this haiku or knows the story of this haiku, but I want you to unmute yourself and take a guess, or you can put it in the chat screen. But my question is, what's happening in this haiku? What's happening? The thief left it behind, the moon at my window.
Is it a shadow?
So you see a shadow in here somehow, okay. Maybe like the shadow of the moon.
Light of moon casting a shadow.
Ah, okay. So we have a, so Ryokan was a lot of the Japanese original haiku writers kind of took a devout kind of stance. So they like became poor monks, decided to live the austere life. So Ryokan was a poor beggar poet monk, came home and his hut was ransacked. And like Jerry, you point out that there was the cast of the moon. And as the story goes that because he was so poor, he was kind of baffled that anyone would rob him. He caught the thief ransacking his place, and the thief ran and a cushion was left behind. And apparently Ryokan chased after him saying, "You forgot my cushion too." I think that's appropriate because Jerry, one of your great haikus is about the mugger taking the old man's stuff, and the old man also gives him his coat because it's cold. It's like very, very, very haiku. Hey, hold on over there, Pitbull. So let's look at another one. All right. Etheridge Knight. Under moon shadows, a tall boy flashes knife and slices star bright ice. All right. This is a whole different picture. So what I'm really asking is, how does this image connect through these images? How does the author use this Kigo to kind of build an image? What's happening here? Somebody else want to take a stab at what's happening in this story?
I think both of them have a connection in finding beauty in despite what might be violent acts or things of that nature. Like with the thief, I'm thinking about broken glass that maybe he left in the yard, and they could see the reflection of the moon. And when this, with this one, you know, somebody's flashing a knife, something's going on, and they can see the gleam of the stars from the knife. So that's the only connection right now that I have.
No, I think that's perfect. So Etheridge Knight is from Indiana. He was incarcerated and became a literary phenomenon while incarcerated. That led to a petition to let him out of jail. It was a big literary achievement in the 70s, but he wrote haiku. And so this is one of his, sorry, my dogs are getting a little crazy right now. So this is one of his haiku. He did write about violence a lot. He did write about kind of like basically the tension between peace and those violent acts. And so you're right. So you have the moon is looking over a tall boy who flashes his knife, and the slashing of that looks like the stars and like bright ice in the sky. So, oh, thank you so much. My bass iron just got me jerk chicken because they're wonderful. I love you so much. All right, so this is Kobayashi Isa. So this is another one that is a very specific story. So tearfully, the child begs me to pick the full moon from the evening sky. Tearfully, the child begs me to pick the full moon from the evening sky. Does anybody, I've got my chat. Sorry, I neglected the chat. I've got the chat up if anyone wants to guess what this one is. Tearfully, the child begs me to pick the full moon from the evening sky. So we look at clues, right? Is this a happy child? Is this a joyous child? We have a child that is tearful. So the story of this haiku is there was a child having a tantrum. And he was tied to a tree. And for a lot of haiku poets in Japan, this would not be an interesting subject matter. The poet would pay attention to the other things going on at the party. But for Isa, this was a important thing. So the moon is so close, why not touch it? So that's a good interpretation. This kid wants this moon that's just like so close to him. But Isa understands that this is an impossible task. So you have a child throwing a tantrum asking the impossible of Isa, and Isa can really only give him a haiku, right? Like that's the only thing that Isa can deliver. So all right, this is also an interesting kind of game to play with Busan, because Busan, one of the four great masters, was also a painter. So a lot of his haiku have been translated into that medium, like basically like people who have made painted versions of his haiku. And this haiku is almost like a painting all in itself. So calligraphy of geese against the sky, the moon seals it. So I want you to picture in your mind like what this haiku looks like visually. And how that correlates to the symbols of the writing too. So there's some interesting like translation with this one. In the original Japanese poem, there's an allusion to foothills being there, which kind of alludes to the shape of the geese. But Robert Haas, who translated that, thought that that wasn't a very clear thing, so didn't include it in the haiku. Oh, excellent, we passed it. So child's, so it's obscured in the hut smoke. Oh yeah. So if you've ever seen a calligraphy master, you know, you've got these kind of like strokes this way, right? And often in Japan, they would have a seal. So we don't know who the moon seal belongs to, but that kind of visually constructs the haiku. So I've got one more. All right, so this one's another fun game. What is this visually representing? Bass picking bugs off the moon. So what is happening in this haiku? Because it's not exactly what it says is happening. It's happening in the cut. Jerry, do you know this haiku? Have you seen this haiku before? Were you saying something? Did you?
They're jumping out of the water to catch the bugs in front of the moon.
Yeah, so they're either jumping out of the water, or maybe the moon is reflected in the water. But basically, there is this image of the like water, the bugs, and the bass, and through more water sound. And Dad, your vote is that you think they're plucking for the air. So Cambridge says the bass using the moon as a trap of sorts. That's kind of interesting, that like kind of like maybe the roundness of like a fishing net, right? But you basically, whatever, whatever that illusion refers to, you can see that construction in your mind. So that's what I want you to think about when you're choosing a kigo and maybe thinking of it, how to write it into a word. Oh, I see IQ's got some calligraphy for us. So we might look to see how that looks like geese. Thank you for sharing that. So Barry, you said the moon is an anglerfish. I like that. So this makes me want to return to our definition that we had of haiku the other day, which is a record of a moment of emotion in which human nature is somehow linked to all nature. A record of a moment of emotion in which human nature is somehow linked to all nature. That is what we're kind of considering in this workshop of how a haiku works besides the rules of 575, three lines, that kind of thing. So I wanna do a couple of quick writing things, and I'm going to ask you guys to participate really quick to kind of pull some of these things together. I feel like I've been leading you on and have not gotten to the point, which happens sometimes. So a quick prompt. What does the word harmony mean to you? What's the word harmony? So we're talking about relationships between human nature and the environment. We talked about the idea of Zen yesterday, about the relationship of the oak tree and the garden. And I want you to consider what this relates to with your own working definition of harmony. So if you don't mind, I want to take literally just 60 seconds, 75 seconds. Think of what you would define in one sentence as harmony and put it in the chat for me. Put it in the chat. Hey Shadow, so yesterday I had a sweet tea to like commemorate the South, but what if I had a cola champagne? Like, what does that say? I mean, that's kind of like repping, right? Like that's right there.
That's to go with the jerk chicken, huh?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Tyron's over there eating a beef patty and I'm jelly. I mean, I could just like the rest of the workshop, just like have you watch me. That's my idea of harmony. All right, let's look at if you're finishing up in the chat, that's okay. But I want to start reading a couple of these definitions. These are great. Cambridge says harmony equals respect. All right, so like maybe like the reciprocity of respect. I dig that. Susan says flow, connection, attunement. So yeah, like how you're attuned to another, or maybe how you're attuned to something in nature. I dig that. Cobra says alignment. Okay, so maybe like kind of like balance. That's an interesting look at it. I'm riffing. Maybe I'm misrepresenting your point. So please give me some poetic license. All things working together in concert, symphony. I like how you put that, Davlin, as a symphony. That's really, really interesting. Harmony is the ability to love unconditionally. I like that, Kendra. So kind of like a source of something that wonderful. Mutualism, beautiful symbiosis. I agreed, Adam, and interesting enough, and this is kind of the of what I'm getting to, interesting enough, more people in the West really think of harmony as this kind of solitude or quietness and peace, where if you would ask someone who grew up with like Eastern religion or Eastern philosophy, Eastern culture, it really is more about that interdependence. It is more about that kind of, we are all one and we're all together and we are a network of energy that kind of feeds into each other. And then it's an interesting thing to consider because there is always this kind of like rift between English haiku and like this like Western haiku and this like kind of Eastern Japanese haiku. I like to think about that. So Jerry said, things that work together, complement each other, creating beauty like music. These are awesome. So I want you to kind of think about this conception of harmony. And I want you to think about how things might have harmony together with your images in a haiku. So yesterday I had you kind of dig up a bunch of different images from your kitchen and from your workspace and stuff like that. We thought about how those kind of compare against each other. Now I want you to think about like, what is the harmony between yourself and this environment, this Kigo that you have thought about? So I want you to kind of start thinking about that a little bit. And I think one way to get us to think about this a little bit is to read some haiku about disharmony. Is anybody into that? Want to read some like emotionally disharmonious haiku? Are you guys ready? I'm excited. Alexis Rotella, discussing divorce, he strokes the lace tablecloth. So you've got a subject, you've got the writer. She's not present in the haiku, but I think you probably get to know a lot about her through the images that she picks. Discussing divorce, he strokes the lace tablecloth. See, Cambridge says he wants to leave her, but knows he will miss her. Right. Yeah, I think that's true. Like he seems hesitant, right? That's a very kind of passive kind of motion for her. And it seems almost nostalgic. Dadam says there's an uneasiness. So the stroke is kind of like a fidget. I think that's a good interpretation. I think that that's really, really, really good read on it as well. And now you can kind of like, even though the writer is not present, because we're thinking about harmony, well, we're thinking about the harmony in their relationship and how they're basically relating to one another. So if he's hesitant and they're discussing divorce, that gives us an idea of maybe where her stance on the divorce is, right? All right, so this one has some context. So Suzuki Shizuku was a sex worker in Japan, and she fell in love with, and then just happened to blow up as a haiku writer, had books published, and decided not to leave her profession. She was actually kind of passionate about it. She fell in love with an American during World War II, and he later died. And so her haiku, Fog. 5,000 nautical miles, Kelly Crack, separated, dies. So this is a very non-traditional haiku. As we discussed yesterday, a lot of haiku written in Japanese are one line, but it doesn't really have a lot of images like we often see in a haiku. It doesn't have the same type of cut, but there's so many little cuts in here. I think one thing that speaks to the disharmony of this haiku is how sterile it is. It is very like informative, right? It's almost like technical. Fog, 5,000 nautical miles, Kelly Crack, separated, dies. Like this might be something that you see like on a telegram or like in like a coroner's report or something like that. And of what we know, this is the only haiku that she wrote about his passing. And she never published it. It was actually collected from a journal after her passing. Haiku said, yeah, yeah, it's almost reads like Western Union. Like that's the telegraph. Nick Virgilio, who we've been reading a couple of his haiku, he has one about a telegram coming from Vietnam about his brother, that the man holding the telegram has a shadow that darkens the door of his mother's home, which is pretty stark. All right, Marlene Mountain, empty mailbox. I pick wildflowers on my way back. Empty mailbox. I pick wildflowers on my way back. So this does allude more to the self than some of the other haiku that we looked at. We have the presence of I, so there is some kind of subjectivity there, but we don't really get any other hint of what her inner emotion is besides the Kigo, right? So we know that there's an empty mailbox. If she's writing a poem about it, it's more likely that she's looking for a letter or some kind of correspondence, right? So Cambridge says, ain't nobody thinking of me, but I'll be happy regardless, right? Bear puts, gives the journey to the mailbox purpose. Okay. Yeah, like I have those days too. Like I even like try to get a package and it didn't come. And then I'm like, well, this day is wasted. That's like kind of like a failure in the pandemic, right? Dad, I'm not empty handed coming back though. Oh yeah. And Cobra's put, I'll give myself flowers. That's a really, really good interpretation of that. Well, no one's giving me flowers. No one's writing to me. So I'm going to get my flowers too. Debt free, no worries. That's what Kendra says. I love that. So no news is good news. That's true, Bear. You know, like it, basically there's nothing of burden, right? So empty mailbox. I pick wildflowers on my way back. So that could, so I think this is like, I love like thinking about whether a haiku is sad or not. And I'm kind of interested in what people think, because this could totally be like a sad haiku, right? She's sad because there's an empty mailbox and then she picks wildflowers on the way back to make her feel better. Or maybe she's like, empty mailbox, I pick the flowers on the way back because I really don't care. I'm not really bothered by that mailbox. So those are some interesting interpretations. Thanks for sharing. All right, I love this one. Okay, so I shared some books yesterday, so I'll be sure to share books again today. So all these come from the Haiku Anthology. This is by Cor Van de Heuvel. I don't know if that's how you pronounce his name, but he's an advocate for haiku. He really likes haiku. And he has been publishing this anthology for 25 years. It's really, really good and has a lot of the really, really great, you know, because there's famous writers who use haiku sometimes, and then we know a lot of the Japanese masters, but sometimes it's really hard to find the passionate English writers who write haiku, and this is a really, really good anthology, and a couple of these come from this. So, George Swede, Sunrise. I forget my side of the argument. So again, this is a very non-traditional haiku. We don't really have like a standard image. There is a verb here, like he's forgetting. So that's a little bit non-traditional in haiku. Sometimes haiku are very image-oriented. But there's still disharmony here. There's still multiple things that are being worked off of each other. And it still uses a Kigo, right? So it uses the environment. And so in some ways, it definition of haiku. So so Cobra says, agreed, maybe it's a silly argument and you need to wake up fresh. Yeah, that's kind of my interpretation. Like, it can't be that good of an argument if he forgot it along the way. That's why you sleep on it, though. That's definitely good advice, Jerry. So Cambridge, you think it's maturity. I personally think he realizes his foot is in his mouth. Like he realizes that, but that is another good interpretation of it. Maybe they had a really meaningful conversation and he has become so empathetic with her point of view that he starts to understand it. So yeah, that's a good read of it too. And that's what I really love about haiku. There is, we talked about Hiroki Sato yesterday, who is the graphic translator. He has one book that is literally the translation of one haiku, like 150 different times. It's the Basho haiku. And that there's been so many interpretations of the haiku that I just think it's interesting that people just see all kinds of different things in the haiku too. So I think I've got one more, and then I'm going to ask you guys to get a little bit of writing in. I am probably going to mess up this name, but this is Ogiwara Seisensue, I think. The Milky Way too has become intense, we said and parted. The Milky Way too has become intense, we said and parted. So chaos, right? Okay, so, you know, I think the Milky Way can evoke that, right? There's kind of just like this like swirling galaxy, like all of this kind of stuff coming along. But, you know, the Milky Way is also like brilliant. It's also wonderful. And what I like about this haiku is it's like, it seems like there's no regrets here. It seems like they're like, we were the Milky Way, but even that has become intense. And we need to part. You know, there's kind of a correlation between like that and the way matter operates in space. So that upsets Shakespeare. I really like this haiku. And this one, so I decided I'm going to try to plug two book each workshop. So this one comes from the Haiku Handbook. I would say that if you were ever kind of thinking about like a good overall primer for haiku, and even if you're like thinking of like a workshop setting of like how you want to take your own practice, like if you want to ever teach, I think this is a really, really good book. So those are my two recommendations. I will drop links to them before we leave today. So cool. So Cambridge says, as the Milky Way becomes more intense, it too will separate. Right, like that's just, you know, so like this, so talk about like the work in the cut, right? So all the things this haiku doesn't says, there is just like a force and gravity that is happening just like in the Milky Way that is between these two people. And that's why you can get a really kind of beautiful haiku out of disharmony in the same way. So we have thought about harmony. We've thought about disharmony. I've had you look at stuff all around your workspace yesterday. I had you choose a kigo today. So I want you to take some time and put all these things together. And I included a self-portrait of Busan. So this is one of Busan's paintings. That was kind of a little interesting, like little history nugget. So write a haiku or few. I'm gonna give you 10 minutes. For this writing time, I'm gonna give you 10 minutes. So write a haiku or few about the harmony between you and the environment. So this doesn't necessarily need to be read as like an environmental poem, but an image from like the bovine, the things that we can see, the material. So how does your own kind of sense of self compare to something that is materialistic in the environment? And I encourage you to try using your kigo if that's your way to get there. But that is one. And if you only write one haiku, that's okay. But if you write a couple or a few, that's good too. Shadow, I might bounce it to you if you've got this pulled up and want to play some music. Are you still there?
Yes, I am. Are you ready?
Well, yeah. Do you want me to stop sharing and give it to you?
Yeah. Awesome. That'll be great.
DJ, drop that beat.
we troubleshooted it, y'all. All it took was me emailing on the PowerPoint. It was it. but I will say, is there a way to switch screens? Because the prompt's a little small.
So you want the echo to be small and the prompt to be large?
Yeah, just so people can
see. Yeah, we can do that. We can certainly do that. Switch them around.
All So I'm also here if you need some help during this time, or if you're confused about the prompt, just put it in the chat. I'll try to make sure. Oh, that's better. Thank you. Making some pretty good time right now. I'm gonna check in 5 minutes, but if after that 5 minutes you want some more time, we've got a little bit of time to work with for this workshop. So I'm just gonna be checking in 5 minutes, okay? 6:51. Thank you. All right, I want to check in with everybody. If you want some more writing time, that's totally cool because we have more time. Or if you want to kind of come back and talk, want to see what you want to do. So put how many more minutes you want of writing time in the chat. You want 0 minutes, do you want 5 minutes, do you want 10 minutes? What do you want? We have a little bit more time. So far, the unanimous is 5 minutes. So if you want longer or shorter, put it in the chat, but I'm going to check back in. Okay. Sorry, 6:57. Just repeated what time it is right now. 6:57. All right. Finish up where you are. You're not okay. That's okay. If you did not write a whole haiku, that is okay. But feel free to put it in the chat. And then I actually want to give some people some time to share out loud either some haiku they've written yesterday, today, or in this exercise right now. Please share in the chat. And then if you want to say anything out loud in a couple minutes, we'll have like a little haiku open mic. I will say, like, during the pandemic, like, I don't miss performing a whole lot. I still gotten like opportunities to do that, but like, I miss like sneaking into an open mic and just like sitting in the back, just like having a beer. Used to be just like pretend that you're hiding, but everybody notices you anyway. All right. All right, everybody. Does anybody want to share their haiku? And I'll put a little spotlight on you. So
I'll share mine.
Sure. Let me put the spotlight on you.
Ready?
Bam.
Okay. In drought, waterfall dies, tadpoles play in mud hole. Wisteria blooms.
So you put your you got a couple of the key going there. Did you get all of them?
I got four.
That's pretty good.
Just lantern. I couldn't tie lantern in, but I thought that was interesting that wisteria they can thrive in a drought. So.
But I don't know what wisteria is. Is it like a vine or is it like a flower?
Like a vine, a flowering vine. That's very pretty. It's very purple, which is my favorite color. So. I tried to get as much in there that was, you know, harmonious with each other. Like I think about those tadpoles and the fact that mud hole is going to dry up.
Yeah. Well, I mean, for using Kigo, I don't think that your haiku seems crowded, and I don't think it, you know, I think it flows really well. So good job. That was great.
I appreciate it. For a first crack, I was happy to get four. Thank you.
Yeah. Any other haiku that you wrote yesterday or today that or any other thoughts you have about the last couple of days? This is kind of like a chance for a go around for everybody.
I mean, I've enjoyed it.
Awesome. All right. Cool. Well, who else is wants to share? Who else wants to share? Anybody? This is a room full of slam poets.
I'll read mine. Excuse me.
Awesome.
Do I have to come off camera or can I just read it this way?
You can do whatever you want.
Okay, well, this is how we're going to keep it then. Excuse me. Surrounded by smog, I forgot how fog rolls in, painting the town white.
Ooh, that's good. Do you want to talk about your haiku a little bit?
I was just, trying to kind of think about, I really love fog. I think it's like, it's dangerous, but it can be dangerous when you're driving and it can make the conditions so that, you know, murder happens. And these days, especially the most recent days, the danger of whiteness comes to me. And so, yeah, it's just kind of equate, even though we think smog is more dangerous, fog can be that way as well.
Yeah. Wow. That's really intense. I like that. Thank you.
Thank you.
You know, I think that like, because like fog's like an apparition, like, and you know, the conversation right now is really, I mean, I just watched the Derek Chauvin trial today because The defense just started. I just wanted to see what kind of ridiculousness they were talking about. So I think that, like, you know, the image of whiteness is really kind of thought about like violence, right? And so, like, when you have like the harmony between that image and the fog, I think that kind of brings up a lot of things. So that's a very powerful haiku. Thank you for sharing.
I appreciate that, Adam.
Yeah, and I'm glad to see you today, even though it's like, you know, it's your like glamour shot.
Right, because back here we're not having a glamour shot moment right now, so yeah.
Well, I'm glad that you're here, so in any way that we get to see you, that brings a smile to my face. Let's see here, Kendra, you said you wanted to share.
Hello everyone, how are y'all?
Good to see you.
You too, thank you. Okay, cutting black grasses, screaming as a candle's flame, afraid to see blue.
Wow. You want to talk about that haiku a little bit?
Sure. And I just kind of stayed on the flame that she had wrote. I wrote a couple of them, but that one was cutting grasses. And I put black in between it. I guess that's okay. I put black in between there, but it's more of like the political, a political piece, just the, using the cutting of the grasses as signifying African Americans that have been shot down. Screaming as a candle's flame is just saying that, you know, easily picked out, you know, you in the darkness, you easily see a candle, the flame that comes up, and then that we're afraid to see blue, you know, afraid of the blue signifying the cops.
Yeah, that haiku does a lot.
Thank you.
Yeah, it's a lot of work. Some of the imagery kind of brings up, I wanted to share, I don't know if anyone's ever read Richard Wright. He wrote Native Son, which is really influential literature. The end of his life, he wrote haiku. I think I'm going to share some tomorrow.
And Black Boy.
You said, yeah, he is good, right?
Well, Black Boy, you know, was written in North Memphis.
Yeah. I have that book. I finally like got a copy of it like a month ago, but I have not read Black Boy yet.
So yeah, he wrote heaps of haiku. Oh my God. Yeah.
Yeah. And you know, that's kind of because so much of his literature was about violence and like white supremacy. And then at the end of his life, he wanted to write haiku. Like that's just what he wants to do. So I thought that was a very, I think that's very poetic. Like, I just think that's an interesting poetry story. I wanted to share some of his haiku today. It just didn't fit the prompt. So I'm going to have to share some haiku because it's interesting. There is, like, we talked about yesterday, kind of the debates historically with haiku. And one of them is that if you make your haiku political, then you are injecting your subjectivity into the haiku, and therefore it's no longer about nature. And kind of like what we talk about, this like idea of harmony, I don't think you can separate those things, right? Like if we're going to talk about the harmony between like the earth and the people, then how are you going to leave out things like violence, right? Like, so
I'm going to ask you about that because I'm going to read the haiku in just a moment.
Okay.
That I guess it kind of goes along the lines of what you're talking about right now.
Yeah.
I want to share something with you really quickly because I know you're a fan of these as well.
Okay.
This is what I was working on yesterday.
Oh, yeah. What is that? Is it an Olympia? What is that?
Yeah, it's an Olympia.
I don't have an Olympia. All right. Completely. So if you're not a typewriter nerd, Olympia is it German or European? What is it?
One was made in West Germany. Yeah.
Yeah. So those are a little, you know, they had, you know, the Europeans had some fancy typewriters. So, man, that's a good get.
I'll show you an Olivetti tomorrow.
Okay. Oh, now you're just flexing. Okay.
I love working on typewriters, especially because with haiku, especially I don't enjoy my phone trying to prompt me or the laptop trying to change my words. And it's constantly sending notifications, like, leave me alone. So the typewriter, I can push everything to the side and get to writing. So these are a couple of haikus you don't mind. I'll read one that I wrote yesterday.
Sure.
Skirting foam middens, silken afternoon sunbeams, bathe the noonday catch.
Can you read that one again?
skirting foamed middens. Silken afternoon sunbeams bathe the noonday catch.
Nice.
I went down to the jetty.
Yeah. Yeah, you said you were going to like take a walk, right?
Yeah, man. I went to the beach, seriously. Yeah.
Nice.
Wow. And this is using, okay, metallic dragon hisses double espresso, coffee grounds stain time.
I love coffee haiku. I even have one that's like about a crescent moon a coffee stain. When I wrote it, I thought it was like super dope, but I'm sure like everyone's written that haiku.
Coffee inspires. More. Romance is rosé. Short stroll footprints have faded. Double shot, neat, please.
I like that cut on the last line.
That was inspired by our haiku yesterday.
Yeah.
With him talking about the footprints on the beach have disappeared.
Yeah.
Yeah. And this is the one I'd be interested to hear your comments, because it goes back to the Richard Wright. Old magnolia, shutters from embedded screams, moonflowers weeping.
Ooh, that's really good. I like how you have kind of two different Kigo tying this kind of story sandwich in between it. That haiku does a lot of work.
Well, it's interesting. I love what Bear did with the Kigo.
Yeah.
That one I was actually looking to have at least two in there.
Yeah.
So, yeah. And thanks, Kendra. Yours was cool as well. I'm glad everyone shared.
I like when you teach poets things like their first rules, like, how am I going to do it? Breaking the rules. I'm going to put all the Kigo in there.
And let me do one last one. This is the one on harmony. Front porch melody. Grief pierces turnip green roots. Grandma's homegoing.
Yes, that one deserves.
Yeah.
That one's really
good. For me, that's a SoFri one. I say turnip greens here, and people look at me like with a vacant expression. Like, what do you mean turnip greens?
Yeah.
And I'm smacking my head. So
yeah.
If I say Vegemite, they know Vegemite, but
yeah. Well, and that's one of the challenges of haiku is basically like you have to set up like two or three premises within just a few syllables, and there's not a wasted syllable in that haiku. There, you have these like three images that just like all come together and tell like a whole like multi-generational like story. That's great. Yeah, thank you for sharing that.
Thanks, Andrew.
Yeah. I want to give, we've got about 5 more minutes. I want to make sure that we give other people a chance to say something if they want to share a haiku or just share some thoughts. I know that some people have been doing this for a long time. I also know some people are pretty new to haiku. So you could either share a poem, share some perspective, whatever.
I'll share.
Yay.
Susan.
Hi, Susan.
Hi. Midnight field, silent, still. I step out of the shack. Fireflies.
I love that. So I like the kind of like progression of it. It's kind of, there's something like transitional about it. Yeah. Do you want to say anything about your haiku or just let it speak for itself?
I'll just talk about the process a little. I love writing haiku, but I was getting in my head about too many things, like too many rules or something, and I had to let go of it. I want to come back to those things and think about them and consider them, but I was letting them crowd too much. But
yeah,
everybody's got their own process, I guess.
I get that way too. And, I think the more I read about haiku, the more I realize how complicated it is. And really the history of haiku is another person saying, that's not a haiku. which I've just really found interesting. Like even Shiki, like the one of the masters, like quote unquote masters, like a lot of people are like, well, what he does isn't really a haiku. And I'm like, oh, I don't even know what that means. And I think, and you know, I don't know if anyone here does speak Japanese or maybe English is not their first language, but I think that's always something that's hard for English speakers to contend with because there is a cultural gap between practices. And so you want to make sure that you are both reverent to the practice. And then, you know, there's also your own kind of insecurity of like, well, I want to do it right. You know, right? Mm-hmm. So I think at a certain point, it kind of can be free. Like, I think we've looked at some examples of haiku that work, but maybe don't necessarily work in the way that someone would want them to work. And every single one of these haiku that we've shared, someone along the line might say that's not how it's supposed to be. Even Basho, who like wrote in peasant language instead of like the courtly, you know. So I hope that tension doesn't last too long because
well, thank you. Thanks everyone. I'm appreciating all of you.
Does anybody else want to share haiku? We've got a few more minutes. I want to make sure everybody, and then of course we can stay a little bit late, but I want to make sure everybody can share if they want to.
I would like to share something if that's okay.
Yes.
I think I did better with the nature in harmony with nature than the me in harmony with nature, but I will start with the ones that were part of the assignment.
Okay.
Mosquito bites me, carries a bit of my blood as we fly away.
Oh.
Okay. Polite hummingbird hovers in front of my face. I feel the feeder. Oh, are you there?
Yeah, I spotlighted you. Yeah. I'll give you some more verbal hmms.
When nature in nature was the one I liked best, though. I'm not in it. Colt frolics along, never far from mother's side, as she pulls the plow.
I like that one.
And then disharmony. Scarecrow stands in field. Fearless crows swarm around him, pluck out all his straw.
That's great. Is there anything you want to kind of talk out about any of yours that you wrote today?
No, just playing with the images and stuff. There was one other one that was me and nature. It was the caressing breeze, carrying scent of roses, touch of lover's hands.
Oh, nice.
Dear, do you write a lot? Do you have a lot of environmental haiku? I feel like so many of yours are about like relationships.
I like to cover a little bit of everything, but yeah. I do often wander into senryu more than haiku. So,
yeah, we talked a little bit yesterday. Like I struggle to separate those two things. You know, like So I like all your stuff, but yeah, I think you've always had, you know, we've kind of been talking about tension today, and I think a lot of your haiku are, you know, like the tug of war with God is like a good example. You know, we talked earlier about the person being mugged. You have a lot of really great haiku about finding harmony and disharmony, so thanks for being a good example.
Thank you.
Does anybody else want to share? We got opportunity if you want to say some words.
I can share one.
Yeah.
To shine at least once, I stand illuminated amongst fireflies.
Will you say it one more time? I missed the first line.
All right. To shine at least once, I stand illuminated amongst fireflies.
That's perfect. That's great. Did you write that one in this workshop?
Yes.
That's a great Whoa. Workshop. You wow. better use that. You better use that in battle.
but not against me. Please don't.
had you been thinking about that one? Talk that one out for us.
As a child, I always loved walking in my backyard. I used to have a lot of fireflies here in Fayetteville. So when you said pick a Kegel word, firefly stuck out to me. And when it comes to shining at least once, it's more about the self-esteem issues I had when I was younger, at least wanting to be seen by someone. So I put that together with the fireflies because they both deal with my childhood.
Yeah. I think that is a haiku that stands on its own. Thank you for sharing that.
And Henzbo, fireflies, if I could be wrong, but I think in Japanese culture, they are something very mystical, almost like otherworldly. Possible death, but definitely the expression of soul is there.
I think they're like something like transitional about them. If we look on that Kigo word, I'm sure that there is the Kigo equivalent of what a firefly is.
You know what I thought of when you said that? You remember that scene in Ninja Scroll where the firefly is on the blade of grass? Okay. So, well, he took me there. I was like, wow, that's really cool.
Is that an anime? I'm like, when my friends get excited Ninja about anime, and I feel like I have the body type of someone that you would assume is in anime, and some people like get really excited about talking to me about it. I'm like, I'm sorry, man.
Ninja Scroll, the movie, is one of the classics from the very late 80s or early 90s.
Yeah.
So, yeah. And there's a lot of natural / supernatural imagery because it is based in like a country prefecture. And so you get a lot of the old Japanese shogunate ideas presented. And there's even one episode on the TV show where the guy who's the guide, he's actually doing haiku.
Yeah. They had like a haiku battle on Avatar, right? Like that was like
I've seen that episode. Yeah.
Yeah. All right. So I want to be mindful of everybody's time. We have time for one or two more people. This is your last chance if you want to share some haiku.
Just real quick, I wanted to tell Lawrence that I thought his haiku was lit. That's a fire.
Thank you.
Love the love. So we were talking about haiku battles. So there is going to be a haiku battle on Thursday, Friday. I know a couple of you are signed up. Shadow, I'm not sure. I need to look at the list tonight, but I think we might have one or two spots. I'm not sure. But if you're still interested in getting in on the haiku list, we at least have a waiting list, but I think that there might be one or two spots that open up. I'm pretty sure. It is close though. So if you're interested, sign up today. That is a competition with $150 on the line. And yes, Cobras, that's in the Echo. If you signed up for this workshop, you should have gotten an email about accessing the Echo. We've got some other great events tonight. Starting right now, it just started. We have streaming the Street Poets open mic. This is Street Poets from LA. And then the other huge open mic, the Poetry Lounge, the famous poetry slam. They're going to be doing an event in the Echo today. So you have that opportunity. If you have merch to sell then we also have an expo space in the Echo today. We're doing a lot of troubleshooting for our big event in June. So if you're interested in participating in that, come and check out the space. Tell us what you think of it, and maybe you'll sell a book or two or something like that. Shadow, is there anything else I'm missing? Oh, yeah. And then we also have a Rengar Writing After Party. That's going to be the last event of Southern Fried. If you want to buy any Southern Fried merch, like my T-shirt here, go to our website. Those kind of things are how we pay for some of our programming. All right. Last thing, I'm going to drop a link in the chat. So we looked at Etheridge Knight's poems today. I'm gonna drop two links actually. So haiku. So there's one by Etheridge Knight. And then I'm going to drop this one also by Sonia Sanchez. So as I said earlier, Etheridge Knight was incarcerated in Indiana. He was petitioned to get out. Gwendolyn Brooks was his teacher. He later had a relationship. It was very contentious with Sonia Sanchez. So I've put both of their haiku in the chat. What I want you to think about is read some of these haiku and see how they list multiple haiku on the same like publication. Like if you were ever to publish your own haiku and you published five, for example, how would you position those haiku? Which is the first, which is the second? What is the harmony between those haiku? If you're curious about digging further, I encourage you to find some other writers who published what we call a sequence of haiku. And I want to hear your thoughts in the next, workshop about what that process is and what that has to do with our conversation about harmony. So that's a easy homework assignment if you remember to do it. If not, that's okay too. Anybody have any questions before we go today? Because that's it for me. I don't have anything else to say.
What is your favorite haiku by Etheridge?
His first one in here about the in this sequence is the inmates sunning on the rocks like lizards. I think
That
one's really, really powerful. I really like. I think that like Etheridge is one of those because like this is kind of a famous sequence. The sequence is so important because the last one is making jazz swing in 17 syllables ain't no square poet's job, which for on its own isn't a strong haiku, but it's such a strong ending to a sequence or series of haiku, right?
Mm. Yeah. Etheridge has some dope poems, obviously. most famous is probably The Idea of Ancestry, but yeah.
I like that one a lot. I like Hard Rock. My favorite is Cell Song. It's about him learning to read and write in his prison. And the last line is, can there anything good come out of prison? Which is the like hypothetical. Can prison produce anything good at all? I think it's a good rhetorical question.
You should check out Ayo Daily.
Okay.
He did a performance of Etheridge's poem about Shine.
I've seen that. The Shine, the Stoker. Yeah. Was that on Deaf Poetry, I think?
It might have been, but I found it just on the video because I was trying to show my daughters some of the poets whom I've had the wonderful pleasure of meeting or talking to at different times, and I want them to see and hear the rhythm because he does such a fantastic job of capturing it in performance.
So for those who don't know, Shine the Stoker is a character that is in a lot of different like East African toasts, like that kind of poetry. So Etheridge Knight, and he is the Stoker on the Titanic. And so while everyone's drowning, he is getting away from all the white foolishness and like, no, I'm going to save my own ass. It is a pretty funny poem. I definitely encourage you to look it up. Anything else? Anybody else have anything good for the greater good?
What was it you were drinking?
Oh, I don't have anything. Oh, it was a cola champagne. It's a Jamaican drink. It's kind of like a ginger ale, I guess. Like it's
okay. Good.
Yeah, I had. I'm gonna enjoy my. Jerk chicken and my cola champagne.
Oh, make me hungry, man.
Yeah. quick thank you to everyone. Thank you, Susan. Thank you, Davlin. Thank you, Dadam. Thank you, IQ. Thank you, everybody, saying goodbye. I'll see you guys this time tomorrow. And those of you into the who are doing the haiku competition, please make sure you sign up for the Echo Creature Avatar and sign in sometimes before Thursday, just so we can make sure you get your tests, okay? So, all right, everybody, thanks. I'll see you tomorrow.
Thank you so much.
Awesome again.
Bye, Jerry.
We were staying in Paris.
Ooh, I miss you so much.
I miss you. I miss you. If I could take this in a shot right now, I don't think that we could work this out on a terrace. I don't know if it's fair, but I thought, how could I let you fall by yourself? Well, I'm wasted with someone else. If we go down, then we go down together. They'll say you could do anything. They'll say that I was clever. If we go down, then we go down together. We'll get away with everything. Let's show them we are better. Let's show them we are better. Let's show them we are better. We're staying in Paris. Get away from your parents, you look so proud. Standing there with a frown and a cigarette, posting pictures of yourself on the internet, out on the terrace. We breathe in the air of this small town, on our own, cutting glass with the thrill of it. Getting drunk on the past we were living in. If we go down, then we go down together. They'll say you could do anything. They'll say that I was clever. If we go down, then we go down together. We'll get away with everything. Let's show them we are better.
Let's show them we are. Show them we are. Show them we are. Show them we are.
Let's show them we are better. We were staying in Paris. Say that I was clever. If we go down, then we go down together. We'll get away with everything. Let's show them we are better. We were staying in Paris. We were staying in Paris.
Hey guys, can you hear me? Hello? You're muted. I can see you, but you're muted. Is that Willow?
Hey, Shadow, how are you?
Hey, I'm good. Willow, how are you?
I'm doing all right, doing all right.
You made it in here, huh?
I did. I came last time, remember, and it was a little confusing, but I think I remember a little bit, but I guess, Shayna, is that how you pronounce her name? She reminded me how to get here to the Expo Center.
Okay.
Hey, guys.
Hey, Lady hey. S. Can you hear us?
I can now. I was watching the video about to cry because I miss everybody now that I've seen it. On the
I know, right? Isn't that such an awesome video?
Hey, what video?
Hey, I like what Yogi did with the place. I was saying that yesterday.
Is there a video showing somewhere?
Say that again.
Can we play it in here now?
Which video?
Can we replay the video?
The workshop?
Yeah, from the workshop.
Oh, yeah, actually.
Video of the SoFried, everybody is SoFried.
Oh, okay.
Oh, that video. Yeah. Where do you want me to put it? It's got to be somewhere that
we can see it, so she can see what I was talking about.
Oh, got you. All right, hold on. Let me follow me.
I can't promise you I won't be over here crying in real life.
Yeah, I know. I know what you mean. Hold on. Follow me.
Okay.
Running too fast. All right, hold on. I gotta grab the video first.
For someone who just made a regional, you don't seem to accept it. I'm not. What are you talking
about? What'd you guys think about the workshop?
I thought it was really good.
Yeah, it was good. I don't know. I told him I have trouble writing haikus, so I did good yesterday. I couldn't really write today, but it was still a good workshop.
Yeah. Yeah, the last 2 days have been really good. Say that again, Willow.
Wasn't able to go yesterday, but today was very beneficial, and it was fun to be writing haiku with a bunch of people. I liked it.
All right. Hold on. I gotta go find it. Give it 1 second here. 1 second, y'all. Willow, was it challenging for you to get into the Echo? Did you have any challenges?
Like just some settings on my computer I had to kind of update since the last time I was here. But no, other than that, it wasn't bad. Just figuring out how to navigate again in this space. So I was like, oh yeah, the go-to function. Forgot about that. And like you were running and I was like, oh yeah, you can like run and dance. I forgot all the things you can do.
Yeah.
Cool space.
There is a lot. Okay. So here comes a video in about 10 seconds.
I'm counting.
the way the screens work, you control, like, what you see on the screen is native to you. Like, we're not, unless we say 1, 2, 3 and click play at the same time, it's going to play at different speeds and rates for us because we're all in different places. Does that make sense?
Yes, it does.
Okay. Alrighty. There we go. Enter. Okay. Now let me know when you can see the video. Should be in there now.
Welcome to the 2019 Southern Fried Poetry Slam here in Fayetteville, North Carolina.
Background. So I'm going to mute it.
We were staying in Paris to get away from your past.
I stepped out, but can you guys see it?
Yeah,
you can. All right, awesome. Cool.
Welcome to the 2019 Southern Fried Poetry Slam here in Fayetteville, North Carolina.
I'll let you guys watch it and I'll be back.
Thank you.
did I walk up too close? Is anybody else coming? Do you know?
I don't know.
Hold on, I can't hear you clear. I think I need to step in front of you.
Oh, yeah. The closer you are,
it's not doing it. It's weird.
I don't know. I was just kind of gonna look around. I see five squirrels. Six of them are in the expo hall, so they all over the place. Yeah, it looks like there are more people in the world.
Okay, yeah, we can find them.
Yeah. Let's see. I'm just gonna go back to the welcome area. Maybe there's people out there.
Okay.
Make some more updates. I've had to go take a small break, but I'm back now.
Oh, you back? Okay, tell us what you did. Or actually, you know what would be really good, since I'm streaming right now? Can you take us on a tour of what you did?
Sure. Can we start in the...
Oh, there's Henzbo. You want to wait till he gets over here?
Hey, it's Henzbo. Got Henzbo. Yeah, love it. Hey, Henzbo, Yogi was gonna give us a tour.
Okay, cool.
Okay, so the first place I want to start you at, now I've been all over this place, like putting images. I'm not gonna take you to every spot because I don't even remember every spot. But I know you said we spent a lot of time in the speakeasy.
Yep.
In the expo. So yep. I want to start at the speakeasy so you can kind of see what I did there.
Awesome. All right, so we meet you in the speakeasy?
Meet me in the speakeasy.
All right, right behind you.
Okay, so welcome to the speakeasy. It's a little red and white action going on.
I like
it. Feel free to explore. Bottom floor is mainly red. Top floor is white. Just
enjoy. Ooh.
We have the after party in here.
Nice.
Thank you. Everything is an image that would spark a poem.
I tried to pick something. Put a lot of thought into that.
Creative and, you know, just hopefully people will say, I was sparked. I had an idea when I saw one of the pictures.
Okay. Y'all don't see me dancing because I'm happy.
Our virtual bath is out of order, guys. Did you know that?
Huh? Say that again.
Our virtual bathroom is out of order. Did you know that?
Yeah, I saw that.
Don't tell nobody.
I don't know if I can fix that. I think it's a part of the aesthetic.
Don't tell nobody.
I know, that was so funny.
So the roof, you know, opens and closes. So right now it's just open, and I feel this is like a nice spot for a speakeasy. And even looking behind us to go out, there's some neon signs, just a little something to be inspirational.
I really like how you really thought this through, honestly. I didn't think you were gonna take it that far, but I'm really happy that you did.
Well, I appreciate that. Huh?
I can't do, but I always know the people who can.
I see, I see. Lady
this
S
is my
to the
second
rescue.
Virtual room, my second virtual or third virtual arena. So this is perfect. This is perfect. I enjoy getting in and doing some different things. So I'm excited that y'all like this. Now I want to take you to the expo. The expo is still under construction.
Okay.
Because all of those booths, if artists don't use them, I want to try to fill them up with something, but we're gonna go look at that next.
All right.
So we'll go to the expo.
You hear that, y'all out there in the world? If you want a booth and you're already a member of SoFried, you can use them. If not, Yogi is gonna repurpose them.
Yes.
All right. Before y'all leave, let me go check out the bathroom. Or actually, I'll meet y'all at the expo hall.
Okay.
Let me show the people the bathroom.
Leave that as a surprise.
This is what people are talking about. No, it's a nightmare. They got a yellow tape? Ugh, that's terrible. All right, go to the expo hall.
Okay, so the expo hall, as we walk in, I don't know how to change this green color with this thing that's right in front of us, but I did change the black to kind of bring people in and draw people in. So as you walk in, you'll start to see that the marketing is there. As we come through, we get a pop of color in the area to our right, kind of draws you in. Can y'all hear me?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, yeah, okay. We had to get a little closer, but we
gotcha.
Can hear you.
Okay.
So what was the part then, you said you couldn't change the color of?
Yeah, this green.
Oh, the carpet?
Yeah, the carpet.
Interesting. Okay.
I'm not sure. I tried to click the buttons and stuff. I could change the part. I changed black so it looked more like a giant screen.
Oh, gotcha.
But I couldn't change the green. But that's neither here nor there, because we still, when we look to our right at the cafeteria conversation area, we have those bright pops of colors which go with green. So it all plays off of each other.
Yeah, I really like that pop of color. It draws your eye to the room.
Okay, perfect, perfect. And so then we have the screens that are, of course, in the back, and we'll come, I'm gonna walk around. The screens that were already decorated here. but that everything in this area just really goes well with each other. So everything is cohesive.
And we're using all this for the June festival, right?
Yes, we'll be using the expo hall again.
Oh, I'm talking about the, okay, never mind. You want to talk to me?
Is that what you're asking, Henzbo?
Yeah, basically.
Okay.
I think this looks great.
Because I can switch it up. I had started thinking about Southern Fried and you know, other images and stuff. But y'all will see. Join me. I'm so excited.
Okay. I'm excited for you.
So here is our celebration of sorts to the typewriter and poetry. And letters and words.
You know, so I like it.
It kind of inspires you to kind of think about letters, words, how they all come together. One image here may not stay. I'm thinking about changing it just to give some more impact. But again, all the images are selected in a way to make someone in the virtual world be inspired to write something in the real world.
Very nice.
Are you streaming this? Because I can't see any images, so it may be my computer.
Yeah, I'm streaming it, and I can see it on the live stream.
I can see it too.
I'm gonna go to the stream.
Okay. This is very nice, Yogi. I like the because Dr. Henzbo is a typewriter fan.
I think
it just plays very well with the theme.
Yeah, we literally talked about Olympia typewriters, which the typewriter on the right is Olympia, in the workshop today.
Oh, awesome!
Oh, yeah, the one on the right?
Yeah, it wasn't an hour ago.
Yeah, one of our workshop attendees has one of these models, and he showed it to us today.
Oh,
this is a,
wow.
German model of a typewriter. Yeah.
So Yogi, you didn't talk to Dr. Henzbo about typewriters? You just picked these?
No.
Wow.
Yeah, I own like seven.
Not at all.
Yogi works on a vibration, guys. She's wonderful. She felt the vibration of the typewriter.
I love it.
I felt the vibration of everybody so far and everything ever poetry. So when we go upstairs, you'll see that it's a little different than your typewriter. So join me.
Okay.
No, I'll take y'all outside. Now, so this is for a little different poet, a little different style of poetry, a lot more, but it's colorful and again, to inspire someone to write, someone to be creative, someone to definitely from start of the room all the way back to be inspired to right.
Wow. This is beautiful.
Thank you. Keep on. Kind of goes with the private chat boxes and it works with just the flow. And outdoors.
Very nice use of color.
Thank you. And this last section. Kind of the completion of all the ideas from graffiti to poetry to color to together we create.
Wow.
Thank you.
And you said you're not done yet?
No, I'm still doing downstairs, working on the booths, trying to get those filled in. Oh, I didn't even take you downstairs. We still have a little bit more to go.
Wait, there's right. more.
There's more. Come along. Okay, here we go. Ow.
Y'all don't want to race me? Y'all don't want to race me?
Let's go outside real fast.
How do you beat me that quick?
I don't know. Okay, so promotional is always important whenever you're doing an event.
Yep.
Promotion is always important when you're doing an event. So having your items outside, your logo outside, and the name of your event outside is also always important. So no one forgets where they are and what they're doing.
I like that.
And it's on the other side as well, on the side of the building. So even when you're outside,
put your name in lights, Dr. Henzbo.
I'm gonna cry.
Gonna cry too.
No, I'm always gonna see my name in a video game.
I know, right? Oh man, this is so nice, Yogi.
It's the marketing and the promotion and placement that's needed.
Oh man.
And then there's one more
okay.
place to show you.
All one right. more.
Okay, I can walk. All along the gray wall is black and white photographs. Do again inspire creativity. And as you go down, it will gradiate down to a different view of the city. So we start on the dark end with light, and then we go to the white with a little bit of dark at the end. So just walk the line. And then there's one more picture on this side.
Oh, I like that one a lot. I really like that one.
Okay.
Yeah, that's good.
Thank you.
Yeah. Thank you. Yeah. Very, very thoughtful. Very creative.
Oh, look, here's my personal advertisement piece. Even if you don't like my poetry, Yogi did the cover.
Stop
people
it,
should
stop
get
it.
My book for one reason or the other.
Wow.
A mess.
I didn't know you had all these talents all the time I know you.
Yeah, I'm just so thankful. So thankful for the opportunity. This is big.
Very nice. And we got it all on the live stream too.
Yeah, we really appreciate you, Yogi. We really do. I know I joke and we have a whole different relationship, you know, but I really appreciate your work and your work ethic. This was really good.
Thank you so much. Thank you. I'm just grateful for the opportunity. I came in and learned how to do it real quick and got it up, and I'm glad y'all like it.
Yeah, I'm really impressed by how comfortable you are in the world now, and you know, just moving around in it and getting to the point where you can design stuff inside the world, which is just awesome.
Thank you. This little learning curve. Like I said, this is my third virtual world. They're all a little different, but once you figure it out, then you can do it.
This is the best world too, right?
Yeah, this is the best world.
Okay. I was trying to tell a joke, but you made it serious, so I'll take it.
Okay.
This is the best world.
With full size people, yes, this is the best world.
Okay. I haven't seen a lot of different worlds.
I'll share a world that I've got that I really like it. But this is the best full size world I have been in.
I just went to a huge academic conference last year. It usually has like 30,000 people at it. I hated their conference platform so much because couldn't see audience participants. They could type in the chat, but you had to like pull it. It was like hard to pull it up. So I just felt like I was like performing down a well. I'm just like, maybe someone's down at the bottom of the well that can hear. I'll never know.
Hello, 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 hello. Anybody out there?
It's a challenge. The virtual world is a challenge, but it's well worth getting into it and learning it, because we're gonna need it.
Yeah. Even if the pandemic quote unquote goes away, I feel like this is something that we can have as part of all of our tournaments moving forward for the people that can't make it.
Oh yeah.
So we need a poetry hug command. Like, can we get our avatars poetry hug commands?
Yeah. What poetry? What?
Poetry. Like, you know how we do the little dance command or whatever?
And oh. Dance? Oh, so that's what you want to do? Hug. Okay, let's do that then.
No.
Yeah, let's do that right now.
If we can get like bear hug, we can give it dap it up.
Yeah.
We can give you pick you up and swing you around hug.
Yeah.
That's what we need for real. But can we do? Let's try hip hop dance long / hip hop dance long in the chat.
Okay, /
Everybody got to be behind me though, so I can see everybody.
Mm.
/ hip hop dance long. Like that. Ladies, you know what to do. Hey. All right, I'm going with the robot next. Robot dance long. You can do twist dance long, you can do robot dance long, you can do house dance long, hip hop dance long, salsa dance long. Hey.
Ew. Get it.
Uh-oh. Lady, yes, you gotta turn around. You got your back to the camera. So I know about that.
No.
Shadow, please come to Southern Pride dressed exactly like your avatar.
Huh? You said what?
I said, please come to the next in-person Southern Pride dressed exactly like
your avatar. I'm going to have to find an outfit. About fit. Just like that.
Yes. About fit.
Okay, Lady S. Yes. I'll see you. I see you over there. Because you got your back to the screen, it looked like you're twerking.
I'll try to find a velvet corduroy jacket.
Yeah, with a green, with the green tie.
Green tie.
Get it, get it, get it. I see you over there.
Is Cuban's thing streaming?
I don't know. This, can we find out?
Did you ever get back to Cuban?
He was in the world and then I didn't see him anymore. So I don't know if he needs any help or support.
Well, I imagine if you're not doing it, he probably was trying to get help streaming or whatever.
Yeah, I just reached out to him.
Okay.
Well, y'all look like y'all tired of dancing.
Okay, yeah, I think things look really good, guys. I'm excited.
Yeah, me too. All right, I'm gonna take a little break. We've been streaming for about, I guess, two and a half hours.
All right.
So I'm gonna cut the stream right now, but it might.
I'll grab a smoothie and see if I can get a boost, and if not, I'll see you guys tomorrow.
Okay. Thank you all so much for your help tonight, Henzbo. That was a wonderful workshop, day two. Let's do it again tomorrow. So I'll be back in the world maybe about 9 p.m. Eastern time. I'll leave my avatar on, but I'll be away.
Okay.
All right.
And I'll be floating.
Good job.
Still decorating.
Thank you, Shadow.
Fantastic job, guys. I'm really proud of the effort today. Very nicely done. I love y'all.
I love you too. Hello. Y'all be good.
We love you too, Yogi.
Love you, Lady. Go check on this album.